Remember when Boston Harbor looked like this? Raw sewage choking all life. Turns out some of the largest and, well, grossest challenges can be overcome by the smallest of heroes. In this case, microorganisms.
And now we're about to get the scoop on
the state's wastewater treatment plant on Deer Island is vast, a 210-acre facility. But much of what happens here is focused on keeping tiny creatures happy.
We're a bug factory, essentially.
Director David Duest is talking about bugs like these, too small to be seen with the naked eye.
So the yellow motors.
He explains the process from flush to finish, up to 2.3 million people's flushes.
We bring all of that wastewater flow into the treatment plant, send it through different levels of treatment to clean it up. We slow the flow down, the settable material actually drops down.
Called the sludge and scum.
Highly technical terms that we like to have out at wastewater treatment.
That material goes to these huge digesters, which produce biogas powering the plant. The matter becomes fertilizer.
Exceptional quality fertilizer that we then land apply in a beneficial way. Hmm. So it's the ultimate recycling.
As for the still dirty water, that's where the hungry little bugs come in. John Wodakowski is a manager in process control.
Where we get the bugs from comes from us, right? Comes in with the wastewater and then the environment. And then we just kind of curate it, keep it happy. That's what makes our process here at Deer Island go.
Well, this is where we're actually starting the process in the bug factory to grow those bugs, those beneficial bacteria.
Duest says what keeps the bugs growing and happy is oxygen.
We pump in pure oxygen that we actually manufacture on site just from ambient air. We pump that into the headspace of these reactors, and then these mixers push that oxygen down into the liquid so that the bacteria can do what they need to do.
This is actually filtering the water that's here in
eating. Wodakowski explains some of the microorganisms crawl, some swim, but most importantly, they eat.
You see it crawling around?
Oh, yeah.
It's got like little legs, kind of looks like a crab or something.
Yeah.
So they call those grazers.
I see him. He's feasting away.
Breaking down nutrients.
I see something that kind of looks like a flower.
Yep, so that's protozoan. They kind of filter the liquid that's left.
Every week, the team here checks samples to make sure the system is in balance. Once the feeding is finished, the water is chlorinated, then dechlorinated, before being released miles from shore through outfall diffusers like this.
By the time we leave this process, we've actually cleaned up the wastewater 94%.
The power of this process and these microscopic creatures is undeniable looking at Boston Harbor today.
When we weren't taking care of the environment, you can see how we can really have an impact on that environment in a negative way. And by actually doing what we need to do to minimize our impact on the environment by putting in treatment plants like you see at Deer Island, we can help improve the environment and also our way of life going into the future.